All right, everybody, happy Sunday night. Welcome to Music on the Menu on the River. Alan K. Stout with you every Sunday from 9 to 10 o'clock, bringing you regional artists doing their own original material from right here in northeastern Pennsylvania, hanging out with Lobo, as I always do on Sundays. Lobo, how are you?
I'm good, Alan. How are you?
I'm doing all right. We had a good week here at the Mohegan Sun.
Yes,
at Breakers.
We did.
We had the guys from Gentleman East here on Tuesday night, and they rocked the joint.
Yeah, they were amazing.
The band is heavier than the Badleys, not as heavy as Breaking Benjamin.
Right.
Kind of somewhere down the middle, which is kind of what you would expect.
Right.
When the Badleys and Breaking Benjamin form a band.
Right.
And, you know, it was nice to have Brett and Aaron here last Sunday. So I thought, you know, let's stay with it. They were kind enough to debut a new track here on the show last week and let us play it for the first time. So I thought we'd play it again. So let's do it. This one's called My How I Have Changed from Gentleman East.
When I was younger, dying a man, I stared up at dark clouds rolling over my plains, and I laughed at the notion that it ever would rain. My, how I have changed. House in the mountains with a dirt basement floor. Found an old violin left by the owners before. And I sat there and listened as it sang its refrain. Daydream. name is Mr. Dirty. Am I really loving away? I am sorry if that you heard it. Is this daydream out of my state?
Dustin Douglas here on Music on the Menu on the River with a song called Daydream. That is from Dustin's brand new record that just came out.
Black Skies and Starlight.
In just a month ago?
Yeah.
No, not even. Actually, the name of the album, you could hear it in the lyrics to Daydream.
Yes.
It's in there. So
it's in the chorus.
Yeah, it's in the chorus to the song, which I like when bands do that. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't have a song on the album
right.
that is the name of the album.
You have to find it.
But you got to find it somewhere. I love when bands do that. I think it's cool. And so it was neat to see Dustin do that. Before that, brand new music from Gentlemen East. Again, new all-star band featuring a couple of guys from the Badleys, Aaron Fink from Breaking Benjamin. The album is not out yet. They're working on it, but they were kind enough now to give us two tracks.
Mm-hmm.
We've been playing one for about a month, and then we debuted another one last Sunday night.
Yes.
Of course, the guys played more songs on stage at Breakers. Speaking of Breakers, might as well tell people now, we will be back in about 3 weeks with Nick Coyle.
Nick Coyle, yes.
Nick has an amazing resume of music here in northeastern Pennsylvania. He had a national record deal at one time with Lifer,
mm-hmm.
you know, some of the guys from Strange with the Candy Driver. He's done some great stuff with the Drama Club. He was with Stardog Champion. He's always been in good bands, and,
mm-hmm.
and his new record is unlike anything he's ever done before.
Yeah, no.
And so we have him on the playlist tonight. I don't know if we do, but we've been playing a lot from the new Nick Coyle record. So Breakers, we'll be back in about a month with Nick Coyle. Let's keep this show rolling tonight with a guy that I recently wrote about.
Yes.
Had an interview with Mike Dougherty in The Weekender, talked a lot about his music. Did not know that Mike was a member of Woody Brown's
mm-hmm.
until I interviewed him. Because he wasn't on the album that we play on the show,
mm-hmm.
so I didn't put it together, but that's really where he discovered his love for soul music. He was really always more of a rock guy, but it was through playing with Woody Brown's that he really got into Stevie Wonder and Marvin Gaye.
I can hear it.
We hear it. Yeah.
I love it. So I'm a fan.
We love the record from Mike Dougherty. So check that out. It's up on my blog, Music on the Menu, or on my Facebook page. If you want to read an interview with Mike, he talks all about his songwriting. A lot of it was inspired by his girlfriend. Sounds like he's crazy about it. Basically wrote a record about the girl, which is great. Nothing wrong with that, Mike. So we like the record. This one's called How You Feel from Mike Dougherty.
How you feel? this curse. Give a hand, spread your love, lift your voice. It's up to you, it's up to me, it's our choice. Stop and chill, try waking up to nothing but the sun. Who are they to say they give up down when their hearts are filled with lies and demands?
Looking back.
Nick Coyle here on Music on the Menu on the River with a song called Anorexy Queen. We talked a little bit about Nick earlier in the show because Nick will be with us at Breakers here at Mohegan Sun at Pocono Downs. He will be our next Music on the Menu live original music series show, which of course is presented by
Fidelity Bank.
Yay, our proud sponsors of the show on Sunday nights as well as Tuesdays once a month at Breakers. Before that, brand new music from Mike Dougherty, a song called How You Feeling Again. Recently did an interview with Mike. It appeared in the Weekender about a week and a half ago. And if you missed that, it's up on my Facebook page. Mm-hmm. Interesting young man, 26 years old. Major influences are, you know, Marvin Gaye, Stevie Wonder, a unique album.
Yes.
And we don't
get a lot of that in this area. So it's I like that. Yeah. I like that album a lot. I
agree 100%. So we've been playing a lot over the last couple months. Let's debut a new song, which is what we try to do almost every week here on the show.
Yes, indeed.
We get so much stuff sent to us, and we appreciate the musicians who listen on Sundays and who send us material. This is a project from northeastern Pennsylvania. It's called One.
Mm-hmm.
It's the name of the band. They have an album called The Awakening, and it is a concept album. You know, the idea of concept albums go back. The first one I remember hearing about was Tommy from The Who, mm-hmm. 1969. Then The Who did another one with Quadrophenia. You know, Pink Floyd, of course, did one with The Wall.
Didn't Yes do one?
I think all Yes albums are
concept albums. I'm pretty sure, yeah, I was going to say. Yeah.
They just don't have an album with a bunch of singles on it. That's not what Yes does. Rush, I think, has done concept albums to a certain extent. So it's something that some musicians have done where you take a whole album and kind of create a storyline. Kiss did it with Music from the Elder. I'm trying to think of some off the top of my head. It's a neat idea to do, and it takes a lot of, you know, cohesiveness. And then to put a song on the radio and pluck it out of that storyline sometimes can be a challenge. Mm-hmm. But I found one that I thought worked good for the show, and I wanted to play it for tonight. This one's called Love Is What We Need from One.
Do you think it's time to to stop being so sublime. Tear down the dividing wall and make this a world for us all. Love's what we need. Change her life, start a revolution by simply standing ground. Always told she ain't good enough, she never gonna amount to much. But she is tired and this time she won't be backing down. She knows it's on the line with people just like her being cast aside, but she ain't giving in this time. And she says, oh, I'm gonna change the world and listen to the lies that they try to throw at me. Cause I can see my worth is so much more than they make me out to be. And I know I am only one, but you can look and find that there's only one of me. And I'ma change the world. And I'ma change the world, yeah, yeah. It was a sophomore year, he checks the list of names, but his ain't there. He thought to himself that they must have got it wrong. All his dreams are thrown to the floor, so he runs home and locks the door. But through his tears, he will find the strength to carry on. He knows it's on the line to show the world that he's a warrior inside. Someday soon they're gonna be seeing 23 in life. When he said, oh, I'm gonna change the world, no one's gonna steal my dreams away from me. Cause I can see the work and know it takes to be the best that I can be. And I know I am only one, but you can look and find that there's only one of me. And I'ma change the world. So you ask yourself the same, do you really have what it takes to be a person who can change the world? And yeah, 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 it's a spark that lights a flame, and it seems to be the only way to be a person who can change the world. She was 17, her whole life laid out in front of her, it seemed.
She had a plan to show the world the definition of true love. It was found in the day-to-day, by the things she do and say. These acts of kindness are gonna start a chain reaction. Yeah, but oh, on that fateful day, a life cut short, a voice taken away. But if you listen, you can hear it to this day. When she said, oh, I'm gonna change the world, everyone's gonna feel the love inside of me. 'Cause I can see the hurt and it's my chance to set a generation free. And I know I am only one, but you can look and find that there's only one of me. Yeah, she said, oh, I'm gonna change the world and everyone's gonna feel the love inside of me. 'Cause I can see the hurt and it's my chance to set a generation free. And I know I am only one, but you can look and find that there's only one of me. Yeah, I said there's only one of me. Oh, I said there's only one of me. And I'ma change the world.
Jared Campbell here on Music on the Menu on the River with a song called Change the World. Jared's a very talented singer-songwriter from up Binghamton, New York. I know I mentioned it on the show here many times because we play him a lot. He's regional because, first of all, it's only about an hour up the road. And secondly, he did some shows here quite often back in the early 2000s, opened some shows with the Batleys. Actually recorded.
He did one at the Luzerne County Fair a couple years ago, opened for the Batleys too.
At the fair, he recorded a live album at the waterfront,
yeah,
which is now called the River Grill, but same joint.
I found out about him when I was going through my like Jack Johnson, Jason Mraz phase.
Yeah, yeah. It was around that time. Mm-hmm. Exactly. That's when Jared was popping into the clubs. You know, and I've stayed in touch with him, and he continues to send me his music. And that's one of his more recent recordings. Great song from Jared. Before that, brand new music for the program. The project, again, is called One, The Awakening. You can check it out. Look for that on Facebook. You can find more information about the project. An ambitious project.
Yes.
You know, to go and do a concept record. You know, Operation Mindcrime, Queensryche, another one. So I'm thinking of the... thinking of the great concept albums in rock and roll. We're going to play another brand new song now. I was up here covering the concert for the weekend. It was a Soul Asylum concert.
Mm-hmm.
I was about a month and a half ago, I guess. They were here 2 months ago.
Yeah.
And these folks that I know, they always come out to our shows at Breakers. Real nice people that support local music. They said, you got to hear Tara Michelle. You got to hear this artist. She plays here at the casino sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't go check her out because I had to go cover the concert. But anyway, I said, well, have her send me some stuff. And she did. And she's from Scranton, and she plays with the group Music for Models. And so she's here, I believe, at Rusty Kitchen at the casino every Thursdays they play. And so, you know, she's right here down the hallway from where we're at right now. She performs here. But she also has this, you know, more of a career than just that. She's recorded an album, and she's had an accomplished career. She's done some work with some major artists in the, you know, I guess you would call it the R&B soul world, mm-hmm. You know, the Alicia Keys type artist, and that's kind of her vibe.
Awesome.
And she's got a really cool record, and I listened to it, and I wanted to play a song from her. So this is Tara Michelle. Probably some of you guys probably have seen her right here at the casino. The song's called Awake.
Stopping now, I'm moving now, yeah. Just like the river goes to She ain't the kind to keep thanks to herself. Yeah, she's the kind to let you know what she's thinking. No, she ain't the kind to keep out to yourself. Is low. She ain't the kind who'll settle for anything less. Yeah, she's the kind to spend up all your money. No, she ain't the kind who's easily impressed. She's a man.
Here on Music on the Menu on the River with a song called She Ain't the Kind. Sue's were one of our bands that played at Breakers.
Our second band, weren't they? It was Eddie.
They kicked it off.
Oh, they kicked it off.
Yeah, they Sue's were first.
Yep.
And then was Eddie.
Yep.
And then I think was Danielle.
Mm-hmm.
And then Grace's Downfall. And then Dustin Douglas. And then Gentleman East. And then after that, we're going to have Nick Coyle.
Yep.
So, you know, we're about 6 months in now on our experiment of putting live original music here at Mohegan Sun on the big stage at Breakers, and it's been going well, and so we do appreciate the support.
Thank you to Fidelity Bank
for sponsoring that event for us and coming out to the shows and sponsoring us on Sundays.
And the musicians who come out to see other bands play, they're really, I mean, they've
we
great.
Have seen that.
Yeah,
we've seen musicians that have come out to some of the shows not necessarily that they were playing, but just to, you know, support the scene.
And the more people we can get to come out to these breaker shows, the more interesting things we can do. So if you're around for our next one, please come out. Come down to Mohegan Sun. It's only an hour. It's early. I mean, you're done by 8 o'clock. It's not like you're going to be, you know, till 11 or 12 and you got to work the next day.
Tuesday night.
But, you know, the more people we can get out to the breaker show, the better.
The perfect time, too, because it allows you a little bit of time to get home from work.
You want to come down, grab dinner down here. You can go right over to Breakers from there. You
could eat here. You could eat at home. But you could still get here by 7, and you'd be home by 8:30.
Right.
So you can't beat that. It's like going to a movie, except earlier.
And it doesn't take 2 hours.
So, yeah, please come down and check our shows out. We'll be back with Nick Coyle in December, and we're looking forward to that. And of course, we just had Gentlemen East here the other night, who rocked the joint, and they were here last Sunday, and what an interview.
Oh, they were great.
I mean, they gave it up. Talked a lot about, you know, what's going on and some of the things,
a lot about their album, the past stuff. the past
Aaron Fink not having the gold records because the record company said you need to pay for it. I just sold you a record that sold a million copies.
You know, we just sold a million copies. How about, and yet we have to force over $125 for a gold record.
That's ridiculous. Shame on you, Hollywood Records. Aaron went to say, I will. I don't work for you. He doesn't either anymore.
Well, they did it to themselves. iTunes. So, I mean, you know.
Oh, man. Let's get the show back rolling here with some music. This is a fun song. This is Jerry Sapphire. This one's called Dipsomnia.
Brick house down. Red Riding Hood, she said to the wolf, won't you 20 days I stayed at this place.
For 20 days it felt like a race.
For 20 nights I stayed at this place.
For 20 bucks I rented a space.
For 20-year-old women lived there.
For 20 High Street breathed the fresh air.
For 20 was the time we all shared.
For 20-year-old girls with long hair.
Time is changing my life. No more pain, no more strife. Come on, give it a try. We'll be flying so high. I'll be free when I'm there, like a bird in the air. Come with me, but don't wait, as if it's 419, you're late.
Yeah.
Christie here on Music on the Menu on the River with a song called Who's to Blame? Great pop song. Our boss, Vince.
Yes.
The man who owns the...
Owns Bogle Media, who has all the radio stations.
Has Vince heard that song, Who's to Blame? He's got to hear that. We got to play that for him. Vince, if you're listening, that's... So many people say they're influenced by the Beatles, because they were. but they tend to talk more about the last three or four. They're the songs you hear more on the radio. You don't hear the Mop Top area.
No.
That's a Mop Top era Beatles song that Tim Huston.
Oh, yeah. Did. On Sundays on the River, we've got Ticket to Ride.
They play it.
Yeah.
They'll play the Mop Top.
And Vince was on there one time doing the President's Show, and he had a bunch of their earlier stuff on there as well.
The Mop Top stuff is cool. I mean, and the River does play it, too. I think I heard I Want to Hold Your Hand or Twist and Shout, in the middle of the day on the River the other day. And I thought, that's cool, because, all you usually hear is the stuff from 68, 69, 67, from Sergeant
Pepper.
It's
so crazy it was that long ago.
It was. Yeah, I mean, those records are 50 years old now. So.
Mm-hmm.
But the great song from Tim Huston, very Beatles. Before that, Terry Cummings, Highway 420, and we kicked off the block with Dipsomnia from Jerry Safire. Terry, of course, from Strawberry Jam. It's a great record Terry put out a couple of years ago. Leaving now with a couple of reminders. We're here once a month at Breakers, and we will be back with Nick Coyle in December.
Yes.
We'll have Nick in. He'll be in the
Sunday before the show.
A couple weeks down the road.
Yeah. We'll get Nick and in. I know it's going to be cold, so, we have valet here. So if you want to come down, you can just park it and come in. You don't even have to park it and walk far. So make sure you come on down. 7 to 8 down here at Breakers.
Got a whole month to talk to you about that and remind you, because that's a little bit. But we're looking forward to coming back again. I'm going to leave you with the Badleys, as I always do. And I was thinking about it as I programmed the show tonight, Lobo. It was 20 years ago, in November of 1994, that the Badleys began work on the album River Songs.
Mm-hmm.
River Songs, in my opinion, is one of the most important records ever to come from Northeastern Pennsylvania. It changed everything. And it really made people look at local music in a different way. And so this one's now 20 years old, believe it or not. The record came out in early 2005. It was recorded around 20 years ago, probably this week. This one's Gwendolyn. We'll get you next week.